Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we shall discuss about the power steering system and some basics about steering system. I am Dipankur and let's get started. Let's begin with the power steering. So power steering is a set of mechanisms and components which reduces the effort applied by the driver on the steering wheel to turn the vehicle in the desired direction. So its main task is to reduce the driver's effort. So before focusing on the power steering system, let us see some basics about the steering system. So the primary function of the steering system is to achieve angular motion of either front wheels or back wheels to negotiate a turn as desired. Rack and pinion is a commonly manual type of steering gearbox used in most vehicles. Now in terms of vertical motion of wheels, vehicles can be of two types. First, rigid axle, in which vertical motion cannot take place, and second one is suspensionated axle, in which vertical motion can take place. So vertical motion of one wheel should not affect the other wheel, and it also should not transmit any impacts on the steering wheel. To accomplish this, we use independent suspension which prohibits the errors. Now talking about steering geometry, Ackerman steering geometry is used to achieve the pure rolling of the front wheels while taking turns. Basically, it uses a trapezoidal geometry which lets more turning angle to inside wheel and less turning angle to outside wheel as desired. Now to achieve the self-centering effect of the steering wheel, positive thruster angle is given to the front wheels. These all points should be considered while designing the power steering system components, because if anyhow power steering component restricts any of these issues, it would not be easy to handle the vehicle, and as it may lose its stability. Now the question arises, why we need power steering? So as we know that how tough it is to steer or even to make a slight turns without power steering, it can seem as though we have to put all our weight into the steering wheel just to make a slight turn. So to make a vehicle easy to handle, to achieve directional stability, power steering is needed. Now there are two types of power steering systems. First one is HPS system, that is hydraulic power assisted steering system, and the second one is EPAS system, that is electronic power assisted steering system. EPAS system have been on the market for a few years and are installed in a small and medium sized car due to its limitation to cope with higher steering forces. So let's talk about HPA system. In essence, hydraulic power steering pressurizes the hydraulic fluid to give us extra power that makes steering our car easier. It is an ergonomic aid to improve control and save maneuverability. Hydraulic power steering system consists of a steering gearbox and an oil pump, a valve. It also includes a double acting power cylinder and a hydraulic oil reservoir. The system becomes active when the exertion of a pressure on the steering wheel exceeds a predetermined value. When the driver turns the steering wheel, it in turn operates a valve. This valve directs the fluid to the either side of the piston inside the cylinder to turn the wheels in the required direction. The valve directs the fluid back to the cylinder to prevent the tendency of the wheels to deflect when they run into an obstruction. Now talking about EPA system, in almost all modern vehicles, electric power steering is in use. Depending upon the speed of the vehicle, electric power assisted steering system offers variable assist to the steering gears. At low speed, the system works to its maximum efficiency compared to high speed. Furthermore, steering angle sensor and torque sensor measure the position of the steering wheel and the torque applied by the driver on the steering wheel respectively. Later, this data is fed to the ECU, known as Electronic Control Unit. In addition, ECU also monitors the overall speed of the vehicle. Based on this information, ECU calculates the assisting torque required to be applied and accordingly signals the assist unit, that is motor, to apply the desired torque to the steering gear. Now comparing HPA system and EPA systems. EPA system is highly accurate system and thus gives a better control over the vehicle. It helps to improve the fuel economy of the vehicle as no fuel is required to run the steering pump. And it is also a lighter system and more efficient than hydraulic system. So that's all for today. Thank you.